Welcome back guys to my YouTube channel. Today we are diving into drone image processing with ground control points using your 3D survey photogrammetry software. Do you want to achieve high accuracy results in your drone mapping? In this video, we'll walk you through every stage from importing images to processing your data with pinpoint accuracy using the 3D survey software. From a bundle adjustment to your orientation process to the 3D reconstruction, and finally generating your orthophoto. Now to start with the image processing, you navigate to your 3D survey software and launch the software. The software interface is displayed. You go to your new project, you navigate to where you have your drone image files. You select the number of images you're using and then you open to be displayed on the photogrammetry software. You go on ahead by setting our horizontal and our vertical coordinate systems. We okay when we end done and import onto our software interface. The waypoint is displayed on the software, including a corresponding base map downloaded over the internet. We can likewise display its telemetry view or the map view, the image and the point cloud view. And we've gone through all the following images. We start with the image processing. We go ahead with our bundle adjustment. We go through the various modes. There's an option for the hybrid mode, the global mode for very large image data sets, and the incremental mode for smaller data sets. We further expand our bundle adjustment property tab, set our feature detection tab, set our pair selection, and then finally our orientation style. When we are okay with them, we start the bundle adjustment process. This usually takes a while to process depending on the specs of your machine, right? Take note, when you have a higher spec machine, it usually takes a shorter time to go through the processing phase. The bundle adjustment is done. The image mosaicing is displayed. We go on ahead to orient our data with our GCPs. So we navigate to where our GCP files are. We arrange them into the various headers, easterns, northern, elevations. We can manually enter them into the various headers as well. This display details the weightage assigned to each GCP. After entering the GCP data, you select the GCPs within the images by clicking on the exact point where each GCP is visible. This step tells the 3D survey exactly where each GCP is located in the real world, allowing the software to anchor your model to the right scale and position. So we start by selecting our GCP number on the far right tab and then corresponding it onto the image. You can go through the images individually or by using our previous or next page on the top right of the software. You select at least 3 GCPs to be able to initialize the GCPs with the images. So we select our third GCP point to continue with our target detection orientation. Mind you, all the targets in red have been deactivated. So to activate them, you double left click to activate them. You rearrange them to make sure the centers align with the green target displaying on the screen. Continue to align the centers to the corresponding grain target for all the GCPs according to the various GCP numbers. This usually takes a while to be able to go through this process. Continue to update the GCP position on the images. This is a display of the accuracies of the images oriented. We can realize from the video that our GCP positions or placement have been updated from its current position after the orientation process. Once our GCPs are set, it's time to generate the 3D model. Click on the processing option and the 3D survey will use the images and GCP data to build a precise georeferenced model. Depending on the area and number of images, processing can take some time, but once completed, you have an accurate scale 3D map of your survey area, ideal for analysis, measurements, or volume calculations. After reconstruction, head over to our mesh to generate our full 3D mesh. Click on calculate to begin the 3D mesh creation process. Finally, head over to your Orthophoto tab to create your orthophotos. Click on calculate to begin the orthophoto creation process. With your model ready, you can export it in various formats such as point clouds, orthophotos, or 3D meshes. These outputs are compatible with GIS and CAD software, making them easy to integrate into other projects for analysis, from land surveys and construction planning to environmental studies. In the subsequent video, I'll be taking you through how to create contours, how to calculate your volumes, and how to perform the various basic CAD functions in the 3D survey interface. With ground control points and 3D survey, you can transform drone images into high accurate 3D models with ease. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more in-depth tutorials on drone mapping and surveying. See you in the next video. It's bye-bye for now.